this is Richard Brodie, reading my book Virus of the Mind, The New Science of the Me. Introduction, Crisis of the Mind. The long-awaited scientific theory unifying biology, psychology, and cognitive science is here. An interdisciplinary effort by scientists over the last 20 years or so, really back to 1859 and Charles Darwin, has produced a new science called memetics. The science of memetics is based on evolution. Darwin's theory of the evolution of species by natural selection utterly transformed the field of biology. Scientists are now applying modern evolutionary theory to the way the mind works, the way people learn and grow, and the way culture progresses. In so doing, the field of psychology will ultimately be as transformed by the scientists researching memetics as biology was by Darwin. For those of us who yearn to understand ourselves, learning about memetics gives us a huge amount of satisfaction. I also believe that people who understand memetics will have an increasing advantage in life, especially in preventing themselves from being manipulated or taken advantage of. If you better understand how your mind works, you can better navigate through a world of increasingly subtle manipulation. Viruses of the mind have been with us throughout history, but they are constantly evolving and changing. They are infectious pieces of our culture that spread rapidly throughout a population, altering people's thoughts and lives in their wake. Mind viruses include everything from the relatively harmless examples, such as miniskirts and slang phrases, to those that seriously derail people's lives, such as the cycle of unwed mothers on welfare, the Crips and Bloods youth gangs, and the Branch Davidian religious cult. When these pieces of culture are ones we like, there's no problem. However, just as the computer virus programs computers with instructions to destroy their data, viruses of the mind can program us to think and behave in ways that are destructive to our lives. The most profound insight from the science of memetics is this. Your thoughts are not always your own original ideas. You can catch thoughts. You get infected with them, both directly from other people and indirectly from viruses of the mind. People don't seem to like the idea that they aren't in control of their thoughts. The reluctance of people to even consider this notion is probably the main reason the scientific work done so far is not better known. As we'll see, ideas people don't like have a hard time catching on. Further compounding the problem is that you don't immediately know whether the programming you get from a given mind virus is harmful or beneficial. Nobody ever joined a religious cult with the intention of getting brainwashed, moving to Guyana, and committing suicide. When the teenage Bill Gates caught the poker-playing mind virus at Harvard, was that harmful because it kept him from his studies? Or was it beneficial because it helped sway his decision to drop out, start Microsoft, and become a multi-billionaire? Every so often, the world of science experiences something called a paradigm shift. That happens when one of the basic, underlying assumptions we've been living with changes, such as when we shifted from looking at the universe as revolving around the Earth to the Earth revolving around the Sun. Another shift occurred when Einstein discovered the relationships between space and time and between energy and matter. Each of these paradigm shifts took some time to penetrate the scientific community and even longer to become accepted by the general public. Viruses of the mind and the whole science of memetics represent a major paradigm shift in the science of the mind. Because understanding this new science involves a significant change in the way people think, it's been difficult for them to grasp. As with any paradigm shift, memetics doesn't fit into our existing way of looking at things, of understanding the world. If you're willing to set aside your current thinking long enough to consider four concepts, some or all of which may be new to you, you'll be rewarded with an understanding of memetics. The first concept, the star of the show, is the meme. The meme, M-E-M-E, is the basic building block of culture in the same way the gene is the basic building block of life. Memes are not only the building blocks of culture on a large scale, making up countries, languages, and religions, but also on a small scale. Memes are the building blocks of your mind, the programming of your mental computer. Second is the concept of virus. It's well known that viruses exist in biology and in the world of computers. Now we'll see they also show up in the world of mind and culture, the world of memetics. I'll draw parallels between the three different universes that viruses live in to show what we can expect from mind viruses in the future. The third concept that contributes to this paradigm shift is evolution. Evolution is one of those words that many people use, thinking they are talking about the same thing, but really having different ideas of what it means. The fourth concept necessary to understanding mind viruses is the new science of evolutionary psychology. This field examines the biases and mechanisms of our minds that evolved to support our survival and reproduction. Memetics builds on these four conceptual blocks to form a new paradigm of how culture evolved and is evolving. It illuminates a major decision point for humanity. Will we allow natural selection to evolve us randomly without regard for our happiness, satisfaction, or spirit? Or will we seize the reins of our own evolution and pick a direction for ourselves? Memetics gives us the knowledge and power to direct our own evolution more than we've done at any time in history. A mind virus is not spread by sneezing like the flu or by sex like AIDS. It's not a physical thing. Mind viruses are spread by something as simple as communicating. In a way, mind viruses are the price of one of the freedoms most dear to us, freedom of speech. The more freedom there is to put forth any communication, the more welcoming the environment for mind viruses. Some mind viruses arise spontaneously, some are created intentionally, but all of them share one thing in common. Once created, a virus of the mind gains a life independent of its creator and evolves quickly to infect as many people as possible. Viruses of the mind are not some far-off future worry. They're here with us now, have been with us since before recorded history, and they're evolving to become better and better at their job of infecting us. Our parents unwittingly infected us when we were kids. If you have children, chances are that you are spreading viruses to them every day. Read a newspaper? Catch a mind virus. Listen to the radio? Catch a mind virus. Hang out with your friends and shoot the breeze about nothing in particular? Catch one mind virus after another. If your life isn't going the way you would like, you can bet mind viruses are playing a large part. Having relationship problems? Mind viruses take over parts of your brain and divert you from what would give you long-term happiness. Having trouble in your job or career? Mind viruses cloud your future and steer you along a career path that supports their agenda, not your quality of life. Cult religions are springing up everywhere, the result of more and more powerful mind viruses. These cults take control of people's minds and make members engage in bizarre behavior ranging from odd rituals to mass suicide. If you think you're immune, remember, nobody ever set out intentionally to join a cult and have their mind taken over. It's the work of tricky and pernicious mind viruses. And once the founder of the cult starts the process, the virus of the mind takes on a life of its own. Because of mass media and direct elections, the U.S. and other governments are becoming more and more subject to infection by mind viruses. A politician today cannot be elected without coming up with an effective image that pushes people's buttons and gets the votes. Politicians' well-crafted images are hooks into some of the most elaborate and pervasive mind viruses infecting society today. What brand of soft drink do you buy? The ones that sell the most cost twice as much as the unadvertised store brands. The extra money goes into television advertising, sending out the spores of ever more penetrating mind viruses that take control of your mind and coerce you to push your shopping cart over to their shelf. Successfully programming your mind to believe that you prefer that brand, advertising agencies are among the most brazen and calculating of the mind virus instigators. The unchecked spread of mind viruses shows up most alarmingly in the state of our children today. Starting with the inner cities and quickly spreading, the mind viruses infecting many kids are pushing them into hopelessness, single motherhood, and gang warfare. Many young people seem to be losing their sense of values and taking off in some very unsettling directions. I have an agenda in writing this book, and that is to make a difference in people's lives. Some of the content found herein could be used for self-improvement. You might not expect a book about science to include ideas from the self-development field, but the science of memetics deals with the mind, with people's lives. Understanding memetics can naturally help increase the quality of people's lives. What new memes would you choose to reprogram yourself with, given the chance? That's entirely up to you. I choose to program myself with memes that support my values in life, rather than ones that support the agendas of viruses of the mind. You can do that or something different. But you won't have the option to do anything like that unless you understand memetics. I believe that knowledge of memetics is important, so I'm spreading the word. Consciously spreading ideas you consider important is one way to combat mind viruses. Ever wonder why, with greater and greater progress and technology, life doesn't seem to get simpler, but just the reverse? Every time you're exposed to.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.